Now children, we will study lesson 2 of EVS of class 5th NCERT book, A Snake Charmer's Story. I am R. Nath. I can do something special which I am sure none of you can do. Do you know what? I can play the bean. You must be surprised. Yes, I can make snakes dance by playing the bean. I have learnt this art from my family members. We people are known as Kalbelias. My grandfather Roshan Nadji was famous amongst our people. He could easily catch many poisonous snakes. He tells me many stories about his past. Come, listen to this, his story in his own words. Dadaji remembers. From the time of my grandfather and great-grandfather, we have always been saperas, snake charmers. Snakes have been an important part of our life. We used to move from village to village carrying our snakes in bamboo baskets. Whenever we stopped in a village, a crowd would gather around us. We would then take our snakes from our baskets. Even after the show, the people would stay on. They knew that in our tin box there were many types of medicines for them. We made these medicines from plants collected from the forest. I had learnt all this from my grandfather. I felt nice that I could help people with my medicines, even if doctors and hospitals were far off. In return, people would give us some money or food grains. In this way, we could manage our life. Sometimes I was called to places where someone had been bitten by a snake. From the marks of the bite, I tried to find out which snake had bitten the person. I would then give a medicine for that, but I have not always been on time to help. As you know, some snakes' bites can even cause death on the spot, but most of the snakes are not poisonous. Sometimes when some farmers would come running for help, shouting, "Snake, snake," I would catch that snake. After all, catching snakes was something I had been doing since my childhood. Oh, those were the good days. We could help a lot of people in many ways. We also entertained them. It was not like today when everyone watches TV for entertainment. When I grew older, my father taught me how to remove their poisonous teeth, fangs. He also taught me how to choose the tube of poison in the snake's mouth. Think and tell, have you ever seen anyone playing a bean? Where? Have you ever seen a snake? Where? Were you scared by it? Why? Do you think all snakes are poisonous? In chapter 1, you read that snakes do not have ears, which you can see. Can the snake hear the bean, or does it dance when the bean moves? What do you think? What can we do? R. Nath, your father used to travel with me ever since he was a young child. He learned to play the bean without being taught. These days it is difficult. Now the government has made a law that no one can catch wild animals and keep them. Some people kill the animals and sell their skins at high prices. So they made a law against this. Now with this law, how will we earn our livelihood? We people have never killed snakes and sold their skin. People say that we keep the snake in bad conditions. If we wanted, we too could have earned a lot of money by killing snakes, but we would never do that. Snakes are our treasure that we pass on from one generation to another. We even gift snakes to our daughters when they get married. In our Kalbelia dance, we also have movements similar to dance of the snake. Arnath, you will have to make a different life for yourself. You have got your father's gift of playing the bean. You and your cousins can form a bean party and entertain people, but do not waste this knowledge about snakes you have got from your elders. Share your knowledge about snakes with children who live in towns and cities. Tell them that they should not be scared of snakes. Help them to recognize poisonous snakes. Tell them how snakes are friends of the farmers. They eat the rats in the fields, otherwise rats would eat the crop. Now you tell our story. Also make a new story of your life to tell your grandchildren. Now children, write down the question answers of this lesson. Question number 1. Have you ever seen anyone playing a bean? Where? Yes, I have seen snake charmers playing a bean. Sometimes they come our colony. Question number 2. Have you ever seen a snake? Where? Yes, I have seen snakes. The snake charmers who come to our colony carry many types of snakes. Were you scared by it? Why? Yes, I was scared because I have heard that some snakes are poisonous. Do you think all snakes are poisonous? No, I don't think so. In chapter 1, you read that snakes do not have external ears. Can the snake hear the bean, or does it dance when the bean moves? What do you think? Snakes cannot hear the bean. They dance when the bean moves. Have you ever seen animals being used for entertainment of people? When and where did you see this? Yes, in circus, parks, roadsides, and sometimes in our colony. I have seen many animals being used for entertainment of people. Question number 7. Which animal show did you see? Answer. I saw the show of monkey, snakes, elephants, lion, tiger, panther, deer, etc. Question number 8. How did people behave with the animals in the show? The behavior of people towards the animal was warm. Question number 9. Was anyone teasing the animal? How? Nobody was teasing the animal. What kind of questions came to your mind after seeing that animal show? Many questions came to my mind after seeing that show, such as 1. Is it fair to use animals for the entertainment of people? Question 2. How are the animals caught from the forest and trained? Number 3. Whether they are handled with care? 4. Would it not be better if they are set free in the forest? Imagine that you are an animal in a cage. Think how you would feel. Complete the sentence. Answer. I am afraid when my trainer beats me if I do any mistake. I wish I could roam freely in the forest. I am sad when I remember my family. If I had a chance, I would run free into the forest. I do not like it at all when people tease me. Like snake charmer, which other people depend on animals for their livelihood. Besides snake charmers, many people like mailman, poultry farmers, tonga wala farmer, washerman, etc. depend on animals for their livelihood. Talk about some people in your neighborhood who keep one or more animals for their livelihood. For example, a horse for a tonga, hens for eggs, etc. Name is the animal they keep. How many animals are there? Is there separate place for the animals? Who looks after them? What do the animals eat? Do the animal ever fall ill? What does the keeper do then? Make some more question and discuss. Make a report on your project and read it over in class. Answer. There is a milkman who lives near my house. He has kept 5 cows. There is a separate construction for these cows. The calves are kept at some distance away from the cows. Milkman and his wife look after them. The cows eat fodder, grasses, etc. Sometimes when any cow falls ill, it is treated by a veterinary doctor. These cows give plenty of milk. By selling this milk, the milkman earns his livelihood. Question number 14. The government has made a law that no one can catch and keep snakes. What do you think about this law? Give reason for your answer and write in your own words. I think this law is in the interest of animals. I have seen many animals being used for entertainment and as means for earning livelihood, such as in circus with snakes, charmers, etc. Of course, they take care of these animals because they earn their livelihood from them. But I think the animals would be happy only if they are allowed to live freely in their natural habitat. Nobody likes slavery. Further, if any animals does any mistake during the training or the show, the trainer tortures it, which is really pathetic. Apart from these, many hunters and poachers kill animals for their skins, tusks, horns, etc. After making the law, such activities are checked. So I think it is good move.